again, wrestling fans, I'm Johnny Cascio. We welcome you to Five-Star Wrestling Action, another outstanding hour of professional wrestling at its very, very best. You'll get a chance to see Johnny Mantell and the judge as they go up against the Texas Knights. Also, Mike George will be with us on Five-Star Wrestling this week. And we will get a chance to see Sam Houston on the card, Mr. Olympia, also the Fantastics. And Rockin Robin will also be on this week's Five-Star Wrestling Action. Much action. We invite you to stay with us. We thank you for joining us. Now get ready for an hour of outstanding entertainment and fun on Five-Star Wrestling.
Officials for tonight's matches appointed by the Louisiana Athletic Commission, your referee, Ricky Proctor, timekeeper, Gary Kilshaw. Match scheduled one fall, 15-minute time limit, with a combined weight of 487 pounds from Muleshoe, Texas. Give it up for the Texas Knights. Knights. At 243 pounds from Monte County, Texas, Johnny Mantell. His partner tipping the scales at 275 pounds from Pecos, Texas, making his first appearance on Five Star Wrestling, the Hanging Judge.
We open the action up with tag team action. Very popular Texas Knights going up against a very formidable team made up of Johnny Mantell and the Hanging Judge. As ring announcer Richard Condon stated, the judge stands 6'6" and tips the scales at 275 pounds. And it will be the judge starting for his team against the Texas Knights. Proctor, the third man in the ring in our opening bout. Judge with the knee to the midsection. Going for the clothesline, and it's the Knight with the arm drag. Getting a taste of the canvas as the Texas Knights have run the opposition out of the ring. As we noted, you will get a chance to see Sam Houston once again as he will take on a martial arts expert. Also, Mike George will be on the card. Junkyard Dog, of course. Mr. Olympia. The Black Olympia. Rockin Robin will be with us. Ladies World's Champion. Plenty of outstanding action, and we're happy that you joined us on Five Star Wrestling. Wrist lock, now the arm bar by the Texas Knight. And the Knight holds on as the judge and the Knight get tangled in the ropes. Referee again, Ricky Proctor, calling for the break and getting a clean one. That's the judge with the upper hand, getting the rake across the eyes. Mantell on the tag. Double team and the double elbows. Mantell, of course, with the running feud against Sam Houston. And Mantell continues to apply the pressure. Tag made with the judge coming in. Now you see the team of Mantell and the hanging judge double teaming, more or less. Again, a hard clothesline by the judge. Judge also feeling the effects of that punch. Texas Knight, however, in a little bit more difficulty at the present time. Mantell with the tag. They have controlled the action more or less from the beginning. Body slam by Mantell. Now goes for the cover. And a two count before the kick out. Mantell rolls up the Knight, gets the two count again. Texas Knight into the boot of a hanging judge, and of course that is an oversized boot, we might add. The statue of that gentleman at 6'6", 275. Mantell missing. And the Texas Knight with the roll into the corner, getting the tag. Mantell feeling the effects of that hard right. And a clothesline puts him on his back. Mantell from behind, and again the forearm across the back of the neck. Mantell goes for the pile driver and nails it pretty good. And that will do it. The three count. Johnny Mantell and the hanging judge getting the decision over the team of the Texas Knights.
Weighing in at 236 pounds from way across Georgia, Snake Watson. Watson. Tipping the scales at 255 pounds from St. Joe, Missouri, the WWA champion, Mike George. George.
Mike George and Snake Watson in this particular match, and joining me at ringside once again, the Junkyard Dog. Happy to have you with us again, JYD.
Thank you very much. I'm glad to be here.
Get a chance to watch the WWA champion Mike George in action. I know a longtime friend, and I know you enjoy watching him in the squared circle.
Yeah, I have the opportunity to tag with George for a few years. I also had the opportunity to wrestle with Mike George. And Mike George is nobody to mess around with.
George running Snake Watson out of the ring and getting the upper hand at the beginning of the match.
That shows that Snake Watson have a little bit of ring knowledge. He's found himself in trouble, so he decided to get out of there for a little while.
Again, we're happy to have you here at ringside, and we're going to get a chance to see you in action at the conclusion of this match by way of videotape, of course. And I tell you, you got your hands full around the five-star wrestling area.
Oh, Dog keep his hands full. Since I've been here, I've been having a sort of a run-in with Buddy Landell and Stanley Akbar in his stable. But things will get better.
With the arm bar and the hammer now by Mike George, driving that knee into the muscle tissue. Jack Howe, referee, asking Snake Watson if he wants to continue on, and of course he does. And with the forearm, elbow smash to the side of Mike George's head, now turns that into a top wrist lock. Now biting. Watson biting the fingers of George and a handful. Well, I know that irritates you.
I tell you, Snake Watson had a little bit of ring knowledge about him and decided trying to take a control now of Mike George, but it seemed like Mike George going to get things back in control, but not as of this moment. Mike George is totally out of control.
Watson to the outside and on the floor.
I told you Mike George is a very knowledgeable wrestler. He's been around the circuit for a while now, and he knows the ins and outs of that ring.
Junkyard Dog again joining us at ringside. Expert commentary from one of the truly greats of professional wrestling. And of course, a big crowd favorite here in the five-star wrestling area. Hard way to come back into the ring.
Yes, it is.
Oh, devastating backbreaker.
Well, George getting nasty in there now. I think the guy sort of got George Daniels riled up a little bit.
Snake Watson again had his foot on that bottom strand of ropes. George ducks the forearm, and again, oh, it really plants one.
Whoa.
You can hear that one way over here.
Oh, yeah.
Again, Watson with a handful of rope, calling for the break.
That's ring knowledge, brother. That shows he's still under a little control in there.
Ray George again continuing to apply the pressure. Driving that knee to the midsection. Watson going up on the middle strand of ropes. Nobody at home on that one, Dog.
No, the lights was on, but nobody's home. Ooh. I think it's over now.
Form of the Bane Buster, and a three count for Mike George as he gets the decision over Snake Watson. Again, JYD, we mentioned you've got a match on videotape coming up. Shinobi was the competition for yourself, and he was more or less taking over for Buddy Landell, who would not face you in the ring. How about that?
Yeah, Landell claimed that he had hurt his arm. And deep down inside, I went for it and saw wrestling with this other guy, and all of a sudden I looked around. Here come Buddy Landell, and I should have known that Stando Akbar always keep ace up his sleeve. I should have known that, but then, like I said again, I was totally convinced that Ben Landell was hurt. So I agreed to wrestle somebody else, which, you know, that's what was due to my contract. So I signed to wrestle somebody else, and then when the match was over, here come Ben Landell, here comes Stanley Akbar. So definitely was nothing wrong with him.
Stay with me, if you will, JYD, and let's take a look at your match with Shinobi. And again, here is Mark Nolte with the call from ringside.
But with the Dog has a grudge against you, like he has for General Skandor Akbar, has been waiting to get his hands on you. General Skandor Akbar could be in a lot of trouble. Now Shinobi, the flying forearm. Drop kick, sends the Dog into the ropes. Oh, the Dog goes off the ropes with a headbutt. Headbutt by the Dog, and he's grabbing a hold of Shinobi's mask to keep Shinobi from going down. At this point, I believe Shinobi wants to go down, but the Dog's keeping him from it. Now Shinobi goes down like he was shot. The Dog bringing Shinobi back up. Crotch hold, lift. Oh, that's going to be it. Oh, vicious swing. Oh, the swing is off. Landell dropping the elbow. It was a ruse. Landell's arm was not hurt. Now Landell's going to use the towel and the makeshift swing to choke the Junkyard Dog. Shinobi, Landell, and Akbar all triple teaming the Junkyard Dog.
And again, we saw the match with Junkyard Dog and Shinobi. Now, we'll be back with more exciting wrestling action, so stay with us on Five Star Wrestling.
Hi, I'm Bernie Strauss. If you get hurt working offshore, first, fill out an accident report.
May 26th, that's when Five Star Wrestling comes to Lake Charles, Louisiana. And now let's hear from the General Skandor Akbar in a pre-recorded interview.
That's the proverbial glutton for punishment. J.Y.D. The legend himself, laying in the middle of the ring. And yes, nature boy Buddy Landell, the fastest rising superstar in the business today. Devastation Incorporated takes care of his people. The beast, well, you can't ask the beast because he doesn't talk. But you see, actions speak louder than words. When you step in that square circle, you have to pay the fiddler. You have to pay the price, the consequences, because Devastation is still king in Lake Charles. Yes, I remember Lake Charles very, very well. And Nature Boy, I know that you have something to say. So listen, and listen good, Lake Charles.
You know, the Junkyard Dog can sit there and he can look over the tape time and time again. But the outcome is the same, dog. You fell for the oldest gag in the world, the sling in the arm. You're an all-day sucker, Lollipop. It's exactly what you are. And the bottom line is, while you're signing autographs and picking your teeth up off the ground that I knocked out, we're riding to the bank with mucho dinero. And one thing about Devastation Incorporated, we're not quick, we're sudden. And we're sudden to strike at any time. On his word, on his command, and his command can vary. Take his head off, leave him crippled, knock his teeth out.
Outstanding card is on tap, and of course you will see the ladies' world's champion, Rockin Robin.
And you know, I can't wait to get back to Lake Charles. I think everybody knows the last time I was there, they know what happened. I was standing in the ring trying to talk to all the nice people, and somewhere from behind me, somebody came, tried to take my title from me. That's not going to happen. That's not going to happen with Naughty, somebody that by the likes of Naughty Natalie either. This young woman couldn't take my title, and neither will you. You might be Naughty Natalie, but I'm bad. Just remember that.
Don't forget, wrestling fans, that Five Star Wrestling action. It's coming to Lake Charles, Louisiana, and that will be on Saturday, May 26th at the Civic Center, which is located by the lake. Come early, plan a picnic, enjoy the afternoon outing, and then enjoy outstanding wrestling action. Don't miss the action again in Lake Charles, Louisiana, on Saturday, May 26th. Back
there.
To the ring.
In the red corner, from Singapore, the martial arts expert, Seinsei.
Mantell and
corner, weighing in at 229 pounds from Waco, Texas, Sam Houston.
Hey, you know what? I'm watching you. Don't you worry about what I'm doing. You better not worry about what I'm doing, boy. You're coming. You're coming.
Johnny Mantell and Sam Houston once again going at one another. Mantell trying to make his way to the ring. Sam Houston invited him to come into the ring.
This guy's taking away from my TV time out here to commentate this match. This guy's really making me mad.
Now we've got Black Olympia coming out. He's got his eyes on the hanging judge. as he steps into the ring. And we have got all kind of chaos breaking out. Sinsei is still in the ring. Black Olympia, Sam Houston. Now, Jack Howe, another referee. Now we have the five-star president, Jimmy Kilshaw, up in the ring. Five-star wrestling president Jimmy Kilshaw in the ring. Wait. Now, Richard Condon handing a mic.
What is it, Mr. Mantell?
Hey, Mr. Kilshaw, this young punk right here wants to wrestle me tonight. I'm not signed to wrestle him. You understand that? You understand that, sir? But I'll tell you what, punk, I don't think you can beat Sinsei, let alone my man, the Hangin' Judge. So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. If you can beat my man, the Hangin' Judge, you can have your TV match with me so everybody can see you.
Well, the match sign is you, Sam Houston, and the martial arts expert. That right?
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
You and me.
Yes, sir. Mr. Kilshaw, Mantell said that if I can beat the judge, then I get my TV match against him. That's the man I want to wrestle right there.
Well, there you have it.
Mr. Mantell. Mr. Mantell, did you say that if Sam Houston beats the Hangin' Judge, he'll get a TV match with you?
That's what he said. That's what he said.
Is that what you're saying?
Okay. That's what the fans want.
Just a minute. Okay. What we're going to do, you have no problem here. If you meet the Hangin' Judge tonight, today, and should you beat him, then you'll get Johnny Mantell. That's what you want. Then what's going to happen then? We're going to match the Black Olympia against Sinsei in the following match. Not now. That's how it's going to be. Sam Houston and the Hangin' Judge.
Okay, we've got Sam Houston against the Hangin' Judge.
You know what, Johnny Cascio?
Where's the judge gone?
It's amazing to me that this young guy has lasted this long in professional wrestling. It's really amazing to me, because he's biting off a little more.
This is a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match.
This guy all about
Sam Houston, you know what the Hangin' Judge.
You know exactly
should Houston win, he gets next week on television, Johnny Mantell.
With a bottle of champagne, celebrating the victory right here for my man, because he's going to tear him apart now.
6 foot, 6 inch, 275 pound, the Hangin' Judge. And the ever-popular Sam Houston.
The verdict's in, Johnny.
And, of course, if Houston wins, he gets Johnny Mantell, who is joining us here ringside.
There ain't no way, man.
Oh, they're trading rights. Sam Houston's got the judge on the run.
Hey, this guy's got to play by the rules now. There's none of that in there. I tell you what, in a fair legal match, this guy, the Hangman, can tear this guy apart day in and day out.
Well, just sit here and we'll see what takes place.
I'm going to sit right here, buddy. I got a front row seat. I may put my feet up so I can watch this real close.
You're laid back and enjoying this, aren't you?
I tell you what, Houston, you're in trouble, boy. You're in big trouble, man.
Mantell continues to taunt Sam Houston. I believe Sam Houston might have the judge's number because he's got his eyes on what's next.
Yeah.
And that is, of course, the gentleman to my right.
Yeah, the judge has got a gavel and a hardwood stone to hit, too, bud.
Houston. Cross body check. Gets a two count. He's got the judge on one knee and backing up.
Come on, judge. Come on, judge. You know, Cascio, you can hear the people yelling that Sam's pulling the tights and pulling the hair, throwing illegal punches. You know as well as I do.
I haven't seen anything illegal.
A punch is not illegal in professional wrestling. Mr. Cassio, you know as well as I do that that's illegal in professional wrestling.
They were exchanging punches right there at the outset
Sam
of the match.
Sam started it. Now we got the upper hand.
Atta boy, Judge. Atta boy, baby.
Small package.
Get out of there.
Judge kicks out on the count of two. Oh, Houston really laying those rights to the side of the jaw. And Mantell is on his way to the ring now. This is definitely a diversion. Misses the swinging right. And Mantell trips him. Houston and the judge tying it up once again. Oh. Judge got that big right up right to the side of the jaw. Now he's got the hangman's noose. The judge has the hangman noose and he's choking Sam Houston, hanging him literally in the ring. Houston rolls over, gets the knee lift. He just used that rope to a good advantage. Let's see if we've got it. Three count. Sam Houston gets the decision over the hanging judge. Now he's trying to use that noose around the neck of the judge. Let's get the official announcement on the match from Richard Condon.
Your winner, Sam Houston.
Let's take a look at it one more time. Sam Houston being literally hanged right in the middle of the ring with the rollover. Then he used the hangman noose to his advantage, hooked that leg and got the three count and the decision. And now he's waiting for Johnny Mantell to step into the ring. That was the stipulation as five-star president Jimmy Kilshaw came out. If he defeated the judge, he was supposed to get Johnny Mantell. Now, Mantell seemingly wants no part of, let's see.
I don't know what Five Star's doing here, but there's a conspiracy. This guy thinks he can beat me, but your day's coming. On the next TV, partner, you all tune in. You all tune in, because you're going to see Sam Houston ship back to Waco, Texas.
The martial arts expert, Seinsei. In the blue corner, from parts unknown, the black Olympia.
Well, we've got two hooded warriors in the squared circle. Seinsei, of course, the martial arts expert, who was to have taken on Sam Houston, being pushed back a match and meeting the challenge of Black Olympia. Sensei, of course, in the dark outfit, and Black Olympia in the colorful red and yellow attire. Sensei with a chop and another, as he has Olympia backed into the to the ring rope on a hard foot kick to the midsection. Excited action, and even more excited action still to come. You'll get a chance to see the ladies' world's champion, Rockin Robin, in action in our very next match. Rockin Robin, very popular, very talented, and a very attractive young lady. The Johnny Mantell and Sam Houston feud continues, and that will have to be dissolved sooner or later. Another kick by Sensei. He continues to apply the pressure to Black Olympia. Mr. Sinsei now feeling the effects. Sinsei continues to use the expertise that he has in martial arts to his advantage in this particular match. Backing Olympia into the corner. Olympia with a turnaround and a takedown. Sinsei, a tall individual. Grapplers tied up in the center of the ring. Olympia once again pushed into the ring ropes. Beautiful. Olympia with the one count could not hold it as Sinsei was a little bit off balance and he could not pin him down and hold him in that particular position. Sensei with some hard chops to the upper part of the chest. Now it's the Black Olympia rolling up his opponent. Inside cradle and see if he can make it hold, and he does with the three count. Black Olympia catching Sensei, coming off the ropes. Got the quick small package and the decision.
Charlie says for the largest selection of beautiful bedding plants in southwest Louisiana, come to Patio Gardens in Sulphur. We have dozens of varieties to choose from, and to keep your bedding plants healthy and beautiful, Charlie says the best fertilizer to use
is... And some outstanding performers will be on that particular card. Now let's hear from Johnny Mantell.
Five-star wrestling only deserves the best there is. And that's what you got standing before you. The judge and Johnny Mantell. Well, I'll tell you what. Mantell Stables doesn't just include horses. It includes wrestlers. So Sam Houston, the Junkyard Dog, Mr. Olympia, Mike George, all you has-beens, you all get ready. Get good and ready. Because the stable of the Mantells is back, Jack, and we're here to do a few things that you all may not like. We're not going to stand out here and tell you how we're going to beat you. We just get the job done. So, Sam Houston, you think about that next time you step into that squared circle. Because the verdict's in. The judge has already called for the sentence, and it's hanging at the next sundown in your Lake Charles arena.
Now let's have some words from Sam Houston.
Johnny, do you know what it's like to feel when you got a rope around your neck and somebody choking the life out of you, choking the air out of you? Let me tell you something. That's what Johnny Mantell had Bob Orton do to me. Well, Mr. Bob Orton, we got some unfinished business to take care of. But first, I want to get my hands on Johnny Mantell. See, he's talking about, hear ye, the court's in session, the court's in session. Here comes a judge. And he's got the hangman judge coming out. He's got a little rope around his neck and everything. He's going to, intends to do some threatening business with me. Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Mantell. I've been around a little while. I ain't been around as long as you, but I've been around a little while. And I can tell you a few things, partner. I've been all over this world, and I've seen some of the toughest competition in the world today. And you are every bit as tough as anybody else I've ever gotten in the ring with. Mr. Mantell, when we get to Lake Charles on the 26th, it's going to make me so happy because two things happen. I get my $1,000 bond back that I had to put up just so I could get a match with you. And the second thing is I get you in the ring. And I intend to take a lot out of your hide. A whole lot, Mr. Mantell. See, you had somebody do something to me that I just didn't like. And I tell you what, the last time we got in the ring together, they had to pull us apart. So it ain't going to be no wrestling match. So why don't you just go ahead and get on all geared up? Because it's going to take everything you got, because I ain't coming to wrestle. I'm coming to fight.
Get ready, Lake Charles. Outstanding wrestling is coming to your town. Back to the ring now.
Now a title match for the women's championship. In the red corner, weighing in at a slim trim 135 from St. Louis, Missouri, Shirley Black.
Yeah.
blue corner, tipping the scales at a nice 122 from Charlotte, North Carolina, Rockin Robin. Your referee, Ricky Proctor.
Ladies World's Champion, Rockin Robin, going up against Shirley Black in this particular match. Ladies featured, and one of the truly talented professional lady wrestlers in the sport today, that being Rockin Robin. And Shirley Black attacks as the bell was sounding. Robin now starting to take over. Hard elbow right to the upper part of the chest. Only can manage a one count. Oh, a hard right. Shirley Black saying that she used her head on that one, and luckily for her, she did, because if she had connected, it might have been Katie Barr at the door. Ah, let's see what's going to happen here. Oh! Rockin Robin getting the best of Shirley Black. That situation. Shirley Black asking for timeout. No timeout in this sport. Right, right up under the chin. This young lady's got to be competitive. She's got to be a power to be reckoned with, because she has the Ladies World Championship, and that is what the competition wants. They're going after that particular goal. So she has got to be at her best every night she steps between the ropes. Speaking of stepping between the ropes, let us advise our five-star wrestling fans that coming in the very, very near future, we will have Steve Dr. Death Williams right here on Five-Star Wrestling. Again, that's Steve Dr. Death Williams, the great Oklahoma All-America lineman, coming to Five-Star Wrestling very, very soon. So keep watching, stay with us, and you will get a chance to see one of truly the world's greatest professional wrestlers and Dr. Death coming to Five Star Wrestling. Referee Ricky Proctor looking over the situation as Shirley Black has a handful of hair. And as you see, Rockin Robin holding on with the hair. Leapfrog, and Shirley Black with a hard right hand across the upper part of the chest. Manages to get a two count, and that is all. Body slam by Black. Using that bolo punch, I guess you would call it, to the small of the back. He's got Rockin' Robin in a bit of trouble right here. Driving the side of the knee into the midsection. Now ramming that shoulder into the midsection. The past minute or so, she has controlled this match completely. Rockin' Robin moving up on the ropes. Oh, comes over the top. Locks those arms down, and that will do it. Rockin Robin gets the decision, and just in the nick of time. Saturday, May 26th. Mark that date on your calendar. That's when Five Star Wrestling will be in Lake Charles, Louisiana, at the Civic Center. The Civic Center, of course, is located by the lake. Come early. Have yourself a picnic with the entire family. And then stay around to bell time and see an outstanding card with Five Star Wrestling. You will see some of the very, very best that wrestling has to offer, like Black Olympia, who will be on that card.
I want to say hello to all the fans out there. Come on out and buy your ticket and have a good time, because I got a good man to my left and a good man to my right. And the dog,
yeah.
I know what you can do.
I know
you got a lot of bones in backyards around that area, and yeah. I want you to show me around.
All right, Dad.
All right.
All right. You know, it's been a long time coming, George. I seen the day when you and I had to wrestle against each other in this great state of Louisiana. And I know, George, you used to give me a run for my money. And the many days I went home to my poor little wife, and I said, hey, Rachel, that guy beat on me like I was a bass drum. She said, well, that's what you get in the ring for. And then when I went home last week, and I told her, hey, baby, I got beat on the bum again. And my mother-in-law made a repeat. She said, was it Buddy Landell? I wasn't going to lie. I said, yes, ma'am. She said, well, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. So ready in Lake Charles, the home of my in-laws, Daddy. And you know when the family get out there, you get that extra 42 right between your body, and it's going to start running all down your bloodline. And then my hair pops up on my head. I look like Don King, and you know. Right then, that you're in trouble, huh? Hey, you're in trouble, Landell. And don't forget Skandor Akbar, Daddy. And then you look around and you see he got himself another man called the Beast. Then he got Kamala. Then he got Mantell. All these guys want to take over Five Star. So what are we going to do, George?
Hey, let them sign their name to the contract. Let them put their name on there if they're brave enough. Hey, hey, I've been all over. I've done it all. I'm not afraid of anyone. If I stood up here and says I was afraid of anybody, I'd be a liar. But I'll tell you what. Step in that ring, and I'll give you a wrestling match that you remember the rest of your life. A lot of people are afraid of me. Like I said, wrestling is what the name of the game. And if all else fails, it's street ball. Who cares? But first, it's going to be wrestling. And then from then on, everything else breaks loose. I've been known. Oh, yeah, I like it, that. I like to see a guy down there go, oh. I like to say, don't hurt me no more. I like that. I like that. I like him. This is a real loud squeal.
Hey, you know, you make a buddy down there with a high pitch.
Squeal.
That's going to be it. Oh, squeal.
Don't forget, wrestling fans, Lake Charles, Louisiana will be the place on Saturday, May 26th at the Civic Center. Be a part of Five Star Wrestling. Come early. Get a good seat. Sit down and enjoy all of the exciting matches. It promises to be plenty of fun for the entire family. Lake Charles, Saturday, May 26th at the Civic Center. Be there. Now back to the ring. Still more action as we promised, and we're going to take a look at a tag team match from the past featuring the ever-popular Fantastics as they go up against a formidable team of Mike Jackson and Steve Pritchard. Mark Nolte has the call from ringside.
Quickly extends the wrist. Beautiful drop, toe hold. Bobby Fulton taking back over. And it's Steve Pritchard, the rookie with the nice move as he reverses the side headlock with a hammerlock. Bobby Fulton looking for something. Comes back up to his feet. Looks like he may try to snap Mara's way out of this.
He'll hit him over the side of his jaw.
And he'll tag Jackie Fulton. Pritchard into the ropes and Jackie Fulton. Nice drop kick.
Nice drop kick.
Jackie Fulton got great elevation on the drop kick there, and he'll fall away on the arm.
Really going to work on that arm, I would imagine. Try to find a place where he can really work on him, bring him down, get him down to a point where he can work on.
That's a real good point, Doug, as Steve Pritchard now backs Jackie Fulton into the corner. Pritchard charges in, he's going to monkey flip Jackie Fulton off the tag. Mike Jackson's the legal man and takes it over with a side headlock. And Mike Jackson and Steve Pritchard are really taking the match to the favorite Fantastics early. Leapfrog now by Jackie Fulton. Goes for the Beal. Jackson blocks it. Fulton takes it back across. And now it's Jackson with the reverse on the Beal. And neither man can gain the advantage.
Real tough battle there. Real tough battle. They're working on it. Arm drag by Jackson.
And they tried to double-team Mike Jackson and just backfired on them.
Takes him over with a double head scissor.
And Mike Jackson controlling the match with his speed. Gives the tag back to Steve Pritchard. Pritchard off the rope with an elbow. And did you notice the way, Doug, that the Fantastics were in the ring 2-on-1 a moment ago? That's not at all a tactic that we're used to the Fantastics doing against a team that's wrestling well within the rules.
No, it's not, but like I said earlier...
And that was a blatant closed fist. I'm sorry, Doug, I didn't mean to cut you off.
That's all right. This Fantastic team seems to be trying to squeak out a victory however they can squeak it out. He's got the man on the ropes, a big slap.
I don't know, Doug, it was hard to tell from that camera angle, but it sure looked awful close to a closed fist. And the crowd sure didn't seem to with a closed fist. Fulton Dutch early. Pritchard going for a sunset flip.
Not gonna get him. Not gonna get him.
Bobby Fulton looking for a tie, can't get it. And Pritchard stays with it. The power of Steve Pritchard evident once he lost the leverage on the sunset flip. And Steve Pritchard takes control of the match yet again with the arm drag. And Bobby Fulton into the corner for the tag to Jackie.
A lot of quick tags going on between these Fantastics. Keeping a fresh man in the ring at all times. I think that's part of their winning strategy, Mark.
And now it's going to be Bobby Fulton taking Steve Pritchard over with the monkey flip. And Jackie Fulton, who is not the legal man, coming off the flying glove kick. Well, I stand corrected. Jackie Fulton is the legal man. The cover by Jackie Fulton gets a count of one before Pritchard kicks out. And now it'll be Jackie Fulton that bars the arm. And Doug, you were talking a minute ago about the way the Fantastics seem to be trying to center the attack on the left arm.
Yeah, I think they're really working on the left arm of this young man. If they can hurt him, get him down, find a weak point in him, possibly they can pin him, make him submit, some of that effect on this left arm.
Well, the Fantastics came out here a little bit cocky early, and suddenly they find themselves, there was no question about that. That was just a handful of hair.
Blatant as it could be, a handful of hair. You just snatched him to the mat. There was no call for that.
And Jackie Fulton's up. Notice the way they cut the ring off on Steve Pritchard. Knee lift off the shot to the midsection. A cover. One, two, and he gets out from underneath.
Not going to give it two.
And the Fantastics are certainly starting to take control of the match. And you have to think of the major reason. And now Jackie Fulton with a shot off the break, or Bobby Fulton rather, and a second one. And I think the Fantastics were a little bit surprised, by the way. And look at Steve Pritchard fire back.
It's about time. He needs to try to get...
Another outstanding hour of five-star wrestling. We certainly hope that you have enjoyed all of the matches. And as always, we invite you to get out and see the matches when they come to your area, live and in person. Bring the entire family. It's great family fun and entertainment for each and every one. Next week, right here on Five Star Wrestling, you'll get a chance to see the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. Also, wrestling number two will be here, Brad Armstrong. The Headhunters will also be on the card, and the much-talked-about match between Sam Houston and Johnny Mantell will finally materialize and take place. So we invite you to join us right here. As always, next week, same time and same station for exciting five-star wrestling action. Until then, Johnny Cascio inviting you to be a part of five-star wrestling when it comes into your home and when it also comes to your town. For the entire crew, join us next week, and we certainly hope you have...